What's up, everybody? Trinity here, and welcome back to the Second Street Marvel. In today's video, I'm going to be reviewing The Amazing Mary Jane, issue number 1. Now, before I get into that, please make sure you're subscribed, click the little bell, give this video a like or a dislike, and you know, and all that other good stuff. So, The Amazing Mary Jane, this is a new series being published by Marvel Comics. The writer of this book is Leia Williams. Or is it Leia? I could be wrong, I'll admit it. And let's see here. On the art is Carlos Gomez. Carlos Lopez is the color artist. And VC's Joe Caramanga is the letterer. And Humberto Ramos and Edgar Delgado are the cover artists. And you can go ahead and take a look at that cover once again. You can tell their artwork just about anywhere. Or at least I guess I kind of got used to it seeing it in some of the Amazing Spider-Man series. So this is a new series. And it's kind of spinning out. In case you've been reading The Amazing Spider-Man, we know that Mary Jane had accepted a job offer, an actress job, to go off to L.A. So she ended up leaving New York and leaving Peter to go off and pursue her acting career. Now, I am a couple of issues behind on Amazing Spider-Man, but I think it's already started to tie into Absolute Carnage, so I think that's pretty irrelevant. But that's pretty much where this book picks up, is once we see Mary Jane is in Los Angeles, and she is actually on set of this movie that she is being part of the production, she's being an actress in. And we can all go ahead and show you right here off the gate. It looks like she's very much playing like a Black Widow type of character here. That's who I'm going to go ahead and guess. And she's there fighting all of these different bad guys. And then they, you know, they end up, you know, cutting the scene. And we see, that's where the story kind of takes off. We see that she goes off looking for the director of the movie, as she has some issues and things that she wants to discuss about the movies, but just seems to have a problem tracking down the director, you know, to have a chat with the director. So she goes ahead and she eventually tracks down the director, and as soon as she finds him, he ends up taking off running, and you know, she takes off chasing after him and giving him a hard time, kind of calling him out. They kind of make a big old scene. Well, as soon as she actually gets to him, she finds out that this director isn't exactly who he appears to be. And after she finds all this out, she kind of finds out a lot about everything that's going on around the set. There are a bunch of different criminals and just bad type of people out there in this here on the set of this movie. And you know, she becomes, you know, just, she kind of takes charge here is what happens. And they make a bunch of, you know, just kind of silly banter between her and the director and exactly what's going on in this story. She wants to go through and make some rewrites and kind of change a little bit of the direction of this movie, as it seems like what she's being part of is this movie that is about Spider-Man. And it actually happens to be glorifying a particular villain of his. And that's something that she kind of wants to change the direction of. And, you know, we see, you know, that here in between takes, she ends up getting on the phone and talking with Peter and having a little bit of conversation with him as he is there. It looks like he's probably somewhere helping stop a, how would you say, maybe like a robbery or a stick-upper, maybe just a crime in progress. Altogether, I gotta tell you guys, like, I don't know, I thought this issue wasn't really too bad, and in case you guys have ever followed me here on the channel, you guys know I'm not a very big fan of Leia Williams' work, and I've gotta say, this issue actually really wasn't too bad. It's just a silly book, just kind of a silly scenario, silly setup, just kind of everything going on in here. Altogether, I didn't think it was a terrible book. The art in it is pretty decent. Again, the story, I mean, it could, you know, it could be better. I've certainly read worse things out of Leia Williams. But I'm going to go ahead and show you the title page here and some of the art, because I think the title page here is just absolutely hilarious. Right there, it looks kind of like a movie ad or a movie poster. Pretty good, and you can see just some of the different art in here. But the art in here is pretty decent. The coloring is pretty well done, and we can see as she's talking with the director here, he starts taking her on a tour of the whole set and everything. And that's what's kind of weird is we see as they're walking through these sets that a lot of them are, you know, they're pretty kind of peculiar. They kind of remind you of just a lot of things in Spider-Man's past, which, you know, it ends up that's kind of what they're shooting is a movie about Spider-Man in a way. Spider-Man is definitely one of the main characters. Now, like I said, this book, it wasn't too bad. There were just some things here towards the end that really kind of, like I said, it's a silly book. And here towards the end, when she's on the phone with Peter, as he is there stopping this crime, just something funny kind of happens. And, you know, we just see, you know, they end up getting into some silliness. And she ends up, you know, sending him a selfie. And they kind of get into it. She makes him start busting a move. You know, they just start dancing over the phone, and he's in the middle of like a Costco or something. You know, like a big box retailer like that. So it's a little odd, little silly. But then what really gets me about this, I'll be bringing you guys some more reviews on this. Is this very last panel right here is kind of what gets me. All right. We got all these villains of Spider-Man's here showing up at the very end of the issue, which is something that's very interesting to me. Like I said, I'm a couple of issues behind on the Amazing Spider-Man series, but I can tell you just from what I have read so far. I mean, I don't know that too much has changed in the past couple of issues. That most of these heroes or these villains that we see here at the back of the book, they're not really big time characters in Spider-Man's story right now, as it has been really for the most part a lot of their female counterparts. So I don't know, just some weird, really odd things going on here. Like I said, this last page of the book definitely has me it got me wanting to read the next issue number 2, to see where this story is going to go to. But like I said, altogether, this book, for me, it wasn't the greatest book in the world. I probably won't be pulling this book, but I will be bringing some reviews for you guys. Like I said, it was a little bit silly. The whole idea is a little bit silly anyway. The Amazing Mary Jane, honestly, I'm not sure if this is just supposed to be a 5-issue miniseries or 6-issue miniseries, but just getting into what we did in this book, I can't imagine that it's going to be much more. And honestly, guys, I mean, if I'm being honest, if I want to be honest with you guys, I'm not sure that Leah Williams should be writing much more than that anyway. I haven't seen in any of the books that I've seen her write where she's really proven herself to be that great of a writer, or somebody that's probably going to be writing more than a handful of issues, probably in this series or maybe any other series. And like I said, I've actually recently did a review of another book that she wrote on another publisher called Chastity. And, you know, like I said, that book, issue number 1, didn't quite do it for me. Issue number 2 was a little bit better. But like I said, I'm not really into her writing. And this book, I mean, it's just kind of a silly setup anyway. But who knows? It could be a fun book, and it might be something that you might like. Like I said, I know for me, it's not anything that's completely, you know, in my something that I would continue to enjoy reading. But like I said, I will be bringing you guys some reviews. But let me know down in the comments below. Did you read the Amazing Mary Jane? If so, what did you think about it? Let's talk down in the comments below. That's all I have for this video today, folks. Thank you all so much for tuning into the Second Street Marvel today. If you haven't already, please make sure you're subscribed and click that little bell so you get notifications anytime I have uploaded new content or anytime I plan on doing a live video. And if you don't mind, please give this video a thumbs up, or feel free to give it a thumbs down. It's all good. I don't take it personally. And most importantly, make sure you share it with a friend and invite them to come hang out with us here on the Second Street Marvel. You all have a very good day. Happy reading. Get out and support your local comic book shop, and we'll see you in the next video. Later.